In this lecture, we are going to establish a connection to MySQL database using PDO. In order to connect to MySQL database with PDO, we need to create an instance of the PDO class and specify the data source name, which is referred to the DSN, the database login credentials, and optionally any other specific connection options. The PHP PDO class actually contains some predefined methods that allows us to easily interact with any of the databases that are supported. Currently in the class, we have 14 methods and a constructor. So just for the benefit of that, for those who don't understand what a class means, the class is essentially a blueprint from which we create objects. For example, we are talking about the PDO class here. We can create an object of this class and then get access to all the methods that are defined in this class, and we can then use them in our application. That's just an aside. You can always refer to other materials to learn more about classes. Basically, a class is just a template. It's a blueprint from which we can create objects, and this object will inherit or contain all the properties in the class. So we have a PDO class here that has 14 methods. So when we create an instance of this PDO class, automatically we are going to have the 14 methods and also have access to the constructor. To create an instance of the PDO class, we make use of the new keyword in PHP. Next in the list is the data source name. This basically contains specific connection information such as the name of the driver. We have mentioned before that currently PDO supports 12 drivers. So you need to specify which of the driver you're using so that PDO will know what kind of database you want to connect to. You need to specify the hostname. This will basically reference the server where your database is stored, and in most cases it will be localhost. And next we have the name of the database. We can also include information like the character set in the DSN string. Next you need to specify the database credential. Here you need to specify the username and the password of the database user who will be making the connection. And the last argument in the constructor when creating an instance of the PDO class is options. This basically is an array that allows us to specify some specific options and the values that we want for those options. This will allow us to determine how PDO behaves. For instance, we can determine using the options argument how we want PDO to handle errors. We can specify here how we want PDO to behave in terms of persisting connections. Basically, this is the syntax to create an object of the PDO class. We need to first of all define a variable that is going to hold the connection, and then we need to use the new keyword followed by the name of the class, which is PDO. And within the opening and closing bracket here, the first one is the DSN, which we have talked about. The next one is the username followed by the password and then the options array. So we're going to create a database now, and after which we'll connect to the database. I'll be using PHP MyAdmin. You can use whatever application that is okay for you. All right, I'm going to create a database here. You click on the databases link and then specify the name for the database. I'm going to name this database library and then click on create. Okay, right now we have the library's database and there are no tables in this database. So I'll go over to my test editor and we are going to establish a connection to this database. So we'll get rid of this. The first thing that we need to do is to create a variable which will hold our connection. I'm just going to call this con. And then we use the new keyword to instantiate the PDO class. We're going to specify the connection parameters, which we've already discussed. The first one would be the DSN. So here we specify the driver, MySQL, followed by column. And then we specify the host. This is going to be equal to localhost, followed by a semicolon, and then the name of the database. So this will be library. Next, we need to specify the username, mine is task, and then the password. As I mentioned before, we can also include an array of arguments here. We're not going to do this now. First of all, just establish a connection. We can just echo connection successful. We'll go over to the browser and refresh this page, and it tells us connection is successful. This is because we were able to actually make a connection to the database. If there were any error messages, it's going to display it here, as I'm going to illustrate briefly. Now that we have successfully established a connection to the database, let us now tell PDO to persist our connection using the options array to ensure that each time a request is made to the database from other script, a new connection is not created. All right, to do that, we need to put a comma here and then create the array. And in here, we say PDO, column, column, which is our scope resolution. And the specific attribute that we're looking for is the attribute persistent. And we are going to just set the value equal to true. As I've mentioned before, this was going to ensure that the connection to the database that we've established here is persistent, because the default behavior of PDO is to actually close the connection at the end of the script. So we can manually close the connection by setting the database handler to null like this. If we don't do this, PDO will automatically close the connection at the end of the script. So setting this attribute persistence equal to true, we override that behavior. Instead of PDO to close the connection at the end of the script, PDO will cache the connection and reuse it whenever another script make a request to the database using the same credentials that we have specified here. Now there's something you need to take note of when using the attribute persist. You must define it within the options array. You cannot use any other method to specify that you want to persist the connection. It must be defined at the same time when the connection is being created. That means when you are instantiating the PDO class. In the next lecture, we are going to see how to undo errors that may occur when we are attempting to make a connection to the database.